Are you procrastinating by watching this video? Continue to watch this video because this might be the last one you watch, after which you'll go and strike that task off your to-do list. Hello everybody, my name is Janani and I am a product manager here in Singapore. In today's video, I am going to talk about the things that have worked personally for me to stop procrastination. We often find ourselves wanting to start something, but telling ourselves that we will do it a bit later, or sometimes we'll be like, hey, let's just do it tomorrow. That's exactly what happened with this very video that you're watching. I was procrastinating shooting it, and maybe I'm going to talk about one of the things that worked for stopping procrastination for beginning to shoot this video. What happens when we actually tell ourselves that we'll do it a little later is a sense of temporary gratification. We feel instantly happy for a temporary duration of time, but actually what happens is at a later time, you're going to regret having pushed it to that time itself. We just end up feeling worse for not having taken up the task earlier. Procrastination is actually something that has happened throughout history. Humans have procrastinated from the very beginning of time, perhaps, which is why Greek philosophers actually have a name for it. It's called akrasia. The ancient word akrasia actually means that you're doing something while you're supposed to do something else. Procrastination. Being in the information age doesn't quite make it easier, does it? We are in the time and age where there are way too many candidates seeking our attention, be it the internet, be it social media, be it the notifications, be it the people around us, and we just have one too many things that seek our attention. And we always end up giving our attention to something that isn't quite what we consciously chose to do at any given point in time. Before I go into the things that actually help me from stopping procrastination, first I want to actually explain the procrastination cycle itself. In an ideal world, when procrastination doesn't exist, that is, akrasya doesn't exist, we have a thought and the thought becomes action. For example, we need to go to the gym. We go to the gym. I need to shoot this video. I shoot the video. We need to pay up bills. We pay the bills. The thought, we need to write the essay. We write the essay. Now, is it really that simple though? Often what actually stops this thought from being converted into action is the fact that we need to feel like doing the action itself. We need an external motivation that helps convert this thought to action. We need to go to the gym. We need to feel like going to the gym. Then we go to the gym. I need to write the essay. I need to feel like writing the essay. I write the essay. I need to pay up the bills. I need to feel like paying up the bills. And then I pay up the bills. So between thought and action, there is an in-between factor, which is the motivation, which acts as a trigger so the action is performed. And in the absence of this motivation and the absence of actually wanting to feel like doing something, basically prevents the action from even being performed. In the book called The Motivation Myth, there is a very different perspective to what motivation itself is. We oftentimes think of motivation to be something that we need in order to perform an action, but there's a very different perspective to it. Motivation is not something you need in order to perform an action. Instead, it is something that you get as a result of performing an action, which in turn triggers the thought-action cycle. So motivation is not something you need, but it's actually something you get. There is actually a tweet that I posted that I've pinned as a reminder for myself, and it reads, "As you probably know, starting is the hardest bit. Train yourself to just start the small attainable bits of a large task. You'll be at the other side of the brick wall in no time." So as I just said, starting is the hardest bit. Once you have this understanding, we can now delve into certain tips and tricks that I use to trick my brain into getting started. The first one, do a pre-task with a timer. Do what I call as a pre-task with a timer. It can be any tiny attainable task, a 5-minute meditation, a 5-minute going to go fill up your water bottle and bringing it back, a 5-minute watering the plant, a 5-minute quick face wash, or a 5-minute cleaning up your desk space. Once you do this pre-task, you get a little motivation to get things done, and then you end up actually starting the task that you wanted to actually perform from your to-do list. Ensure you keep a timer before doing this pre-task so that you don't start procrastinating by doing this pre-task into the time that you're actually supposed to start the task. A timer helps. I, however, have the most recommended pre-task that has worked personally for me. Any kind of physical exercise, even a little bit of stretching or yoga or a run, helps you feel an incredible amount of dopamine to fire up the other tasks for the day. It doesn't matter if you're just stretching or you're going to the gym to lift like 100 kilos, just do what works for you. But get started with the pre-task to fire up a little motivation. Second thing, I call it the reverse Pomodoro technique. The basic concept of Pomodoro clock is where you do a task for 25 minutes and then you have a 5-minute break, and then another task for 25 minutes and again a 5-minute break, so on and so forth. While the Pomodoro technique actually really, really helps beat procrastination, I have a little twist, especially when you're getting started with something. Before I talk about the reverse Pomodoro technique, I wanted to talk about why this concept even came into my mind. It is because of Parkinson's law. What does the Parkinson's law say? The basic concept behind Parkinson's law is based on the deadlines you set for any activity. The Parkinson's law says that the work expands to fill the time that you actually have to finish the task. So without a deadline, there is no pressure to finish the task. But not every single thing you do is going to have a deadline, is it? So what can you do? You can trick your brain into believing that there is actually a 5-minute deadline. I use an app called Forest for the Pomodoro technique. So what I do is I set a 5-minute timer. You can even use your phone app's timer and set a 5-minute deadline to get started on the task. You set a 5-minute timer for what you're about to do and then get started on it. Say you're only going to do it for 5 minutes and then take a break. For example, you want to start writing an essay. Just write the introduction paragraph of the essay in the next 5 minutes. That's the only thing you're going to do. Keep the deadline, finish that paragraph, and then stop doing the task and take a break. You know how you watch your Netflix shows and you leave a show in like a cliffhanger and then you really want to get back to it? Trust me, it actually works. This doesn't just work for Netflix, it also works for your regular tasks at hand. Once you get started on this task and leave it halfway, even if you take a break, you are going to want to come back to this. This leaving behind a cliffhanger actually has a psychological term for it called long-term potentiation. So it doesn't just work for watching Netflix or Amazon shows, but it actually also works for the tasks that you have at hand. Try the psychological trick and let me know if it works for you. The third and the last hack is something that I've seen personally to work for me, which is basically recording a time lapse of you doing the task. As most of you privileged watchers might already own a smartphone at hand and might already have a time lapse functionality within your phone, you can set a time lapse recording yourself doing the task. If you don't per se have the time lapse feature in your camera app, there are plenty of apps in the market which actually help you perform this. Set yourself recording a time lapse of you doing the task, and this somehow works incredibly well for me, and I get a lot of stuff done productively when I use this technique. And those are a few ways in which you can get started with tasks, get some motivation, and use that motivation to fire up other tasks, and hopefully it helps you beat procrastination. You can get started by doing a pre-task that is super easy to accomplish in under 5 minutes to get that motivation to get started with your next task. A self-set 5-minute deadline by starting the task that's already at hand and leaving a cliffhanger, and I feel like you'll definitely come back to finish the task at hand. Or the last one, record a time lapse of yourself doing the task and you might actually amaze yourself and finish it. Voila, these have worked for me and helped me stop procrastination. Let me know if they actually work for you as well. There is no one single solution or one solution that works for all. If you have other tips and tricks that have worked for you, do let me know by getting in touch. And I hope you find at least one of these useful. Thank you for watching. Please do like this video and help me tell the YouTube algorithm that this is actually useful to you so it can actually help a few others as well. Do share the video and as well subscribe to my channel.